on the founders of H Street. It's been 10 years since Mike Chemansky and I got together with a team of mostly unknown skateboarders and made Shockin' Enough. I decided to make this special edition video collection for those who were there at the time and for those who are just coming into skateboarding, the grommets. At that time, skateboard videos were professionally made and not filmed with cheap VHS cameras that we used. And most people didn't edit their videos in their living room, but that's exactly what we did. In this video, I'm going to tell you a little bit about the H Street Skateboard Company and show you a few previously unseen clips. Some of them may not be the best skating, but they're pretty fun to look at now. But before I do, and as you can tell, skateboarders like me aren't that good at acting, a point that Mike Chemansky, Danny Way, and myself proved so eloquently at the end of Shackle Me Not. But we had fun, acting like idiots, and the part turned out just about as stupid as we thought it would, so that was a good thing. The other day I was skateboarding in Snow Valley with my son Shane, which is a great skate park outside LA, and I saw this little kid, Peter, 5 years old, just rolling around the park, having a great time. He doesn't know anything about H Street, doesn't know who Danny Way is, Matt Hensley, Ron Allen, or any of the guys. But he skates for fun, which is the reason that we started H Street and made the videos in the first place. And fun is the reason that I still got a skateboard now on 34. After Shackle Me Not, H Street was a skateboard company that was on the map. We were selling boards, and Danny Way, Matt Hensley, and Ron Allen were household names. No one had seen a skateboard video that was made as haphazard as ours. This was a cool thing because it meant that anyone can make a skateboard video. And that's exactly what hundreds of kids did. I know because they sent them to my office. Anyway, here's a couple of shots that never made the video.
Danny Way was 14 years old when we filmed Shockin' Me Not. The amazing thing is how small he was compared to how good he was back then. I think these shots of Danny are even before he rode for H Street. Ron Allen's nickname was The Fly, and he was definitely the original rail and big ollie guy.
It's 8 to 7 in your... We made a lot of trips while filming. Usually, you end up with a lot of good footage when you travel. One time, we went to Tijuana Skate Park in Mexico. Mike wanted to film some lines, so first we tried to have Mike follow me and John Sonner. This turned out kind of squirrely because the snake ground was sketchy and kind of gnarly, and Mike didn't skate that well to begin with. So then we tried to have John Sonner hold the camera and more or less film his foot point of view. So we went on to film some other stuff in the park. Mike may not have been the best skater in the world, but he was really good at making deals with people.
Yo, Action Jackson. How much? For the flags.
How much for everything?
$2. Yeah. About 50 cents. Is that 50 cents?
Yeah,
I got 50 cents. 50
cents? 2 quarters?
50 cents?
25?
$2.
Right here, bro.
Oh man, 75 cents. 75 cents?
After realizing that Tijuana Skate Park wasn't so hot after all, we left.
Need the camera!
What?
Need the camcorder!
That one?
That one? Right now?
Wait, hold the wheel for a second.
I think so.
We didn't get that much accomplished that day, but we all had a really good time. A trip to skate camp in San Francisco proved a much better idea for a video. clear a few scrap clips.
Super skate cam. Cernowski. Meathead. Get off the street course. Now it's Rich's turn to rock the mic. Finally my turn to rock the mic. Supersonic skate camp.
Tony Mag was there. Catching real high air.
I ride aboard by 8th Street. Called the Comic. The real rat board. Got Hellbound Cave. Hellbound Cave. Hellbound Cave. Hellbound Cave. Real steep tail. Once you go to hell, you can't come back.
After Shacklebeanot, we met the ever notorious Sal Barbier, who joined the team and filmed like mad with the rest of us. The following year came Hocus Pocus, probably the most watched skateboard video of all time. Before filming Hocus Pocus, we all went on tour in Europe. We didn't get that much footage, but here's a few clips that never made the video. We went to the trade show in Long Beach. At these shows / mega parties, you're supposed to show up all your new stuff, including videos. So here's a little promo that we made for Hocus Pocus.
Guaranteed. The plot, your musical biscuit. H3 Video is coming soon to a theater near you. Much less a video shop or a skate store to tickle your technical fancies. Make your big balls turn blue as the boys go off in Hokai Polokai, the new epic feature from 8th Street. Don't miss it. Available February 15th, 1990. Know what I'm saying, boy? It's available when?
February 15th, 1990. Pretty convenient date.
Sure, right after the trade show. Great, great idea. God, those guys are jerks. They're all after our money. Trust them.
After Hocus Pocus, we started filming right away for the next H Street video, which ended up with the name Not the New H Street Video. I suppose this was kind of a joke from the start. Not the New H Street Video was never really finished. It was really only half the footage we had. But this is when Mike and I separated, and most of the footage had only been seen by team writers and a few kids that saw the bootleg copy that a couple of the writers had. Here are a few clips that did make it into the vid, including some pretty funny spills. We called the second half of the Not the New H Street video the Summer Tour video. Like Not the New, the Summer Tour video was never really finished the way Shaglin Hocus was. It had only been shown at a couple of trade shows in promo format. So for the first time ever, here's the H Street Summer Tour video.
come here.
What?
What's your problem? I told you don't do this. If the owner walks in here, I'm fired. You understand that?
I know, but we were leaving.
You're going to find me a job?
I know you guys.
Wait.
No.
Later.
Hit him the way up. And then sing by three.
Well, Jason didn't make it here today, but when I grow up, I'll come back here someday and make it.
Tina?
An old cowboy went riding out one dark and windy day. On a ridge he rested as he went along his way. When all at once a mighty herd of red-eyed cows he saw, a-blowing through the ragged skies, and up a cloudy throne. Yippee-yi-yi!
destroys the night. Night divides the day. Try to run, try to hide. Break on through to the other side. Break on through to the other side. Break on through to the other side, yeah. We chased our pleasures here, dug our treasures there.
We get around
talking about my generation.
Things they do look awful.
Talking about my generation.
I hope I die before I get old.
Talking about my generation.
Take my generation. Take my generation, baby. Why don't you all fade away?
Talking about my generation.
Don't try and dig what we all say.
Talking about my generation. What we all say.
Trying to cause a big sensation. Just talking about my generation. Cause we could get around.
Talking about my generation.
Things they do look awful cold.
Talking about my generation.
I hope I die before I get old.
like smoking lightning. Heavy metal thunder, racing with the wind. And the feeling that I'm under. Yeah, I got it for me.
The summer tour video was supposed to be a promo video for Next, but this is when Mike and I split, so a lot of the footage wasn't good for either one of us to use. That's why it was never released. Before parting company though, Mike and I started Life Skateboards with Ron Allen and Planet Earth Skateboards with Chris Miller. Some of the 8th Street riders went on to these teams and both companies produced full-length videos. Here's a live video of Soldier Story.